Right, now onto the serious stuff.
Yes.
Well, not that serious.
Wow, but... you're making me scared now. You're like,
no, no.
Okay, let's get serious.
No, I used to do BA in at One Extra, so like broadcast assistant.
I was as well.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. You were too.
Yeah, I was a broadcast assistant at One Extra for about 2 to 3 years. Freelancing, it was like my first real kind of like looking to radio kind of behind the scenes. And it was through One Extra that I did a competition with Ricky. And that helped us get signed to an agency called Something Else. And then from there, we got our gig on KISS. And KISS was really like the really big gig for us. And that, after that, obviously work breeds work. And then it went on to bigger things. So we went to MTV, we did 4Music, we did Big Brother's Big Mouth. I recently did The Extra Factor. We've got a really big gig coming up on ITV later this year. So a lot of stuff's happening. So it was a blessing to do anything like that.
But I wanted to ask you more about that time. Did you know that you wanted to be a presenter at that time?
Yeah, I did. Yeah, I think I'm quite a creative person, and I kind of wanted to get involved in everything. I think if you're a presenter and you understand how to make stuff, that makes you an even better presenter. My time at One Extra was really important because I got to see how everyone worked, and I got to work with some really great people like Ace and Biz, like Rampage, like Jason and Yaro, like Robbo Ranks. And then when I went to KISS, I saw some really great specialist DJs like David Rodigan, Shorty Blitz, and I saw how everyone kind of worked, and then I kind of saw what I wanted to take from them and what worked for me and what didn't work for me.
What kept you motivated in those times?
The fact that, like, I came from uni and ended up living back at home with my mum. And I just knew that there's like more work for me to do, and I wanted to always like be able to support my mum and help my sister out and just make people laugh and smile and stuff. And I thought, you know, there's so many people that I look up to who are doing great things out there. At the time, I used to really love Richard Blackwood.
Oh yeah, so did I.
Like, do you remember Select MTV?
No.
He used to do a show on MTV called Select, and it was like almost like...
I didn't have MTV.
Oh, right. Don't worry. Just cable, don't worry. And so like he used to do this, it was like continuity links, and he'll play music in between it. And he used to make me laugh so much. I was like, that looks like the best job in the world. And I used to listen to like Trevor Nelson. I used to work in the shoe shop as well. I used to listen to Trevor all the time, and I was just thinking,
Trevor used to work in a shoe shop too. You
listen,
know?
See what I'm saying? We've got a lot of common, and we've got no hair as well. And I just thought to myself, if they can do it, then why can't I? And that's what kind of kept me motivated. It's nice to have role models like that. And my mum's she's always been a hard worker and an inspiration to me. And I thought, you know, I remember saying to myself, I don't mind working hard as long as I enjoy doing it and I enjoy doing what I do.
So hard work contributes to it too, right?
Yeah, I think without working hard, we're still working hard now. I mean, without doing that, you wouldn't get to where you are. If you ask most people who are successful, all the people who are performing today, Tiny, Izzy, Raleigh, all of these guys work so hard. Like, Raleigh's making music and he's killing people in Game of Thrones
exactly.
At the same time. This guy's like hustling hard, like doing everything. Everyone here, hello miss, everyone here is working so hard. And I think without that, then they wouldn't be here today.
Sorry, I just got thrown. I saw Maya Jammer and I was like, oh, Maya Jammer. She always looks great. Exactly. No, I've been asking everyone this, their perception of failure. How do you perceive failure?
It's a lesson. That's all it is. I make mistakes every single day. I don't see it as failure. I see it as just a lesson. Do you know what I mean? Without mistakes, that's sometimes it's the best way to learn. And I think it's the best way to get over your fear of things. So yeah, failure's not even a word that comes into my vocabulary.
Nice, I like it. Because we're trying to get a positive spin on it. We'll just see how people perceive it. So I liked your answer very much.
Thank you.
Thanks so
Have
much for your
day.
Time.
Yeah,
I'm going to see you at Snowboarding.
Yeah, we'll see
I'm
going
to send this
Speak
to three
sponsors.
And be like, send me out. See you later. Thank you.